Hey guys, this is David Kwan here to answer the question. So yeah, hey, why? How did you end up deciding to become vegan, and what made you do that? It's an interesting question. It's fairly a common question to hear, and I don't have like an easy soundbite answer to that. I'm not like a vegan who can answer like, hey, yeah, I watched Earthlings, and that movie pretty much be like. Was a wake-up call, and that was pretty much my beginning course to this journey of becoming a vegan. I don't have like a specific thing or that specific moment in time when something happened. It was kind of an epiphany at the time when it happened, the day that I decided to do this, which was March. Well, when I decided was March 28th, but when I actually started doing it was March 29th, 2010. So pretty much 3 years ago, around this time. And it's something that I've always kind of considered. Not always, but like it's something that really bothered me a lot of times throughout my life, when I was not, a vegan. And mostly, I wasn't a big meat-eating fan. I didn't really like cheese all that much. So it was not a hard, like a super hard transition diet-wise, although it was a hard transition. But it wasn't like super hard. And I really assume, I think for most people, if they do really have the passion behind it, it wouldn't be super hard as they would imagine it to be. It can have a lot of challenging moments, sure. But it was something that I always questioned, like, why do I eat this? It's like the a lot of I don't know, I think Joss Whedon hits on this theme a lot in the series Buffy the Vampire Slayer. I know this is a weird reference here, but in there, the villains are always kind of like the ones that seep life away. Vampires are ones that suck the blood of another living being in order to stay, in order to survive, in order to continue to, be healthy, I guess, if that's the word. And that's kind of how I always viewed my eating habits. I am taking life away from this thing that is chicken. I've always had this like kind of weird connection to it. Like, in order for me to survive, I have to take the life of something else, something that used to live as fully, had emotions just as me, had feelings, had desires. I'm taking that away just so that I can have those things. It's something that bothered me a lot of the times, and even before I became vegan, I remember posting a blog on YouTube. Just going, like, oh, I wish I could become vegetarian. I remember making a video like that and just holding this like chicken taco in front of the camera and just being like, I wish I could be vegetarian. I don't know how that could be possible. So it's kind of always something been like I've been considering. I never really had much research about. And then I suppose I did start researching a little bit about it. I think the biggest impact that made me switch was this podcast. Done by Colleen Patrick-Goodreau, and she is the host of the Compassionate Cook. Her podcast, I believe, is actually called Food for Thought, Compassionate Cook. And in it, she talks a lot about important reasons why becoming vegan is such a choice to live as compassionately as you can, to be as least harmful as you can to the planet, to the animals around you, and just live this life where you live true to your values and your ideals, and not have to worry about, not have to feel guilty about what you're eating, what you're wearing, and things like that. I think that podcast overall is probably the one that had the biggest impact on me. But it even then, even after I listened to that, I still didn't really start doing it. Even after I started watching like Meet Your Meat kind of, I forgot what it was, but there is this website. But if I find it, I'll link it to the video description. But there is something that it shows how factory farming is done. It was like a 10-minute video of like brief snippets here and there of the realities of factory farming. It's just like, holy crap, that's some serious stuff. So it got me thinking a lot, but it wasn't like that. March 28, 2010 was when I went out and I went to KFC, bought this box, like, bucket full of chickens and coleslaw because I loved coleslaw back then. And KFC back then was like my favorite fast food place. So I go there, I buy this awesome meal, I go home, And maybe it was because I had a lot of alcohol, but I drank a lot of stuff. And so I'm feeling like kind of like, whoa, and I'm eating. And all of a sudden, this emotion of guilt that I've carried along about eating meat up to that time, I think it just hit me right then. And I just started crying. I just started bawling out crying, not being able to finish like 5 pieces of chicken left in this bucket. And I'm just like, I can't do this. Like, I can't finish eating this, like, ever. That was, like, the feeling I got. It was such an emotional feeling that just, like, just hit me right there. And I don't know why, but then I just started having all these weird rationalizations. I'm just like, well, if no one ate cows, whatever, then, you know, there wouldn't be all this methane gas produced, whatever. And I just started thinking about, like, all these weird random thoughts. And I think it's from that moment when I was just like, I can't do this. I'm becoming vegan. This was rather like impulse decision right there, even though it's kind of something that's been building up to that. I don't know what made me do that. I don't know what it was about the vodka I drank or the KFC that I ate. But in my own room, it's like, what, like 10 at night, 10 o'clock, 10 p.m. or something. And I'm just like, I can't do it. I feel if I eat this, I'd be feeling way too guilty to be able to continue. And that was how I came to decide. And after that, it's just been kind of been a journey to stay as vegan as much as I can. You know, to not any animal products, to not wear any animal products, to, you know, just constantly be on the mind about, you know, animal rights issue and environmental issues, like animal testing and all that kind of things. That's kind of when I started, like 3 years ago, just that moment and just thinking up to it. And really, I think my biggest resource for me was Compassion to Cook and Colleen Patrick Goodreau's words as I'm listening to it on my iPad and later on my iPhone, you know, just listening to her hundreds of episodes on this topic and her just reasoning voice, I think really helped me. So that's one of the reasons why I donated, I don't remember how much I donated, it wasn't that much, but it's just like, wow, you helped me change my life pretty much because of the words I listened to. So I donated to her websites, which is CompassionToCook.com. So that was pretty much how it all started.